Hey Suzu. What's good, everybody? Welcome in, welcome in. Salutations. Greetings. Good to see you. We're going to be doing all 12 houses. Tarot Tuesday. General readings for the collective. Starting with Aries, moving all the way to Pisces. Welcome in, Purple and Dash. Salutations, everybody. Greetings. We're just getting started. Just turning on, just tuning in today. How's everybody feeling? What you grateful for? Can you hear me alright? Music okay? As I mentioned, we're just getting started. We are just getting started. We're going to be reading for all 12 houses. Birthday's on Thursday. Happy early birthday, babe. Good energy indeed. Salutations, everybody. We have the Hermetic Tarot here. As well as the Zen Osho Tarot here. We're going to be reading for all 12 houses today. General readings for the collective, starting with Aries, Sun, Moon, Ascendants. Wherever you have Mars in your chart, wherever your first house is, this is for you, my dudes. We also will be playing with the Goddess Power Oracle. Reading the messages that want to move through for the collective. So welcome in, welcome in. Sit back, relax. We all have all 12 houses in our charts. If you don't know anything about your natal chart, your astrology, I highly recommend you go look it up. It's a great way to get to know about yourself on a deeper level. We're going to begin in just a moment. Let my dudes jump in. I don't want to keep y'all waiting. I see there's already 132 in here. Outstanding. Appreciate you being here. Your presence is a gift. Thank you for sharing this space with us today. Stoked to get started. The real ones remain. Absolutely. We'll begin with Aries, Sun, Moon, Ascendant. Move it all the way to Taurus, Libra, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Today. The real ones remain. Salutations, my dudes. If you can hear me okay, maybe drop that sunflower emoji so I know that you can hear me. Carrie says, how long are you doing this? Seems like so much to learn. It's a joy to learn. In fact, we're teaching a class this upcoming Thursday, May 18th, on the tarot, called Intro to the Tarot. We'll be diving deep into the deck, the language that is this transcendental technology that we call the tarot. If you'd like to learn more about that, general admission is now live, and you can purchase yourself a seat on my site, zentthealchemist.com. Rachel, Brianna, I see you. Stormy, I see you with the sunflowers. Thank you for your feedback. What's good, Mage? Welcome in. Welcome in. We are ready. But before we begin, I simply want to say thank you. Thank you to all of our guides, all of our angels, all of our aliens, all of our guardians. Watching over us and allowing us to tap in today to share these messages, to be here as a cosmic conduit, as a channel. What a gift it is. What a joy it is. So stoked to see these messages for the collective. Susie, thank you for the gift. The gifts are always appreciated. Absolutely. Your presence is an absolute gift. Thank you for sitting here with us today. 333 likes up there. I see you. Cinnamon Ray, what's good? Salutations, everybody. Christine, Oppers, good to see you, my dudes. Greetings, greetings, greetings. Mage, thank you for that. Rose, I appreciate you. We are just about to get started. Do we have any Aries in the house? Any Aries, Sun, Moon, Ascendants? Wherever your first house may be, Aries, first house is the house of identity, the house of the ego, the house of who we are eternally throughout time and space. First house today. Any messages for the collective? Let's get to it. We're going to cut the deck. We'll clear the energy. We will let it rest. We'll shuffle these cards here. We are ready. For Aries, first house, wherever you may be. I see you, I see you. Let's get right to it, my dudes. We're going to cut the deck. We're going to clear the energy. And we also invite in a goddess. Ooh, Ah, yes. Only two cards right side up for the first house, and this is a proper first house reading. First, we have the King of Cups here, right side up in the draw of the Hermetic Tarot. Prince of the Chariots of the Waters, King of Cups. Alongside the Hierophant here, in reverse, in the draw. The Majesty of the Eternal Gods. Lord of Perfected Work. Four of Wands here in the root. All is mind, this is the truth. We have Awareness here, in reverse. In the draw for the collective, first house, we have the Source here as well. And we have the Compromise card here, reverse in the root. All three cards from the Zen Osho Tarot are in reverse. We have Bronwyn, the goddess of forgiveness, also in reverse. Right now, we're being reminded that the ultimate goal is our connection with our own personal source, the divinity within. And where this communicates is through the water within. King of Cups here, right side up, reminds us that we can listen to and connect to the divinity through our intuition. Our intuition speaks through our water, through our emotions, through our feelings, so those subtle inclinations that cannot be expressed. Lord of Perfected Work over here in the root is reminding us that this is a daily, consistent path. The Hierophant here is an individual who has a discipline that they can continue to return to, show up, and replicate. The Hierophant, as opposed to the High Priestess, the Hierophant is someone who practices their magic on a consistent basis. So finding your personal practice that allows you to connect to your intuition, reminding us that connecting to one's intuition is a daily practice. The intuition is a metaphysical muscle, and we're capable of continuing to dive deeper into it by bringing our awareness to our sensations rather than reacting to them, but more so sitting in the seat of the witness, sitting in the seat of the observer, and connecting to source with intention, connecting to the divine spark within you, forgiving all of the experiences that one has gone through thus far that has created disconnect, that has created separation. Yes. You are not here to compromise your connection to your intuition, to source. You're not here to compromise your awareness for anybody. You're here to commit to this path of self-knowledge. Because ultimately, this is what the path of spirituality is all about. Getting to know oneself throughout all lifetimes, all levels, all layers. Yes, the truth remains. Shouts out 42 out here. I see you. 42 is the answer to the universe, according to the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Right now, we're being reminded of the importance of every day connecting, at least for 5 breaths, at least for a moment, to allow yourself to return to your center, to clear all of that stuff that has been built up, to allow yourself to process the process so you can show up present, in your presence. Your presence is an absolute gift, and thank you for sharing it with us today to co-create this experience. What a joy it is. We're going to keep flowing from Aries, house number 1, into house number 2, Taurus, values. How we apply our knowledge of self, and how we allow it to continue to take shape in our reality through the core. This is the key to perfecting the work. Yes, knowing that everything is a grain of sand. If it resonates, bring it with you. If it doesn't, release it. These are collective messages for all 12 houses. We are flowing forward to house number 2. If that resonated in any way, shape, or form, maybe drop your comment of one of your favorite ways to develop your intuition, to connect with source, one of your favorite ways to create. Let me know. I'd love to read. Shouts out, Odessa. We flow forward this evening. House number 2, Taurus. Wherever you have sun, moon, ascendant, Taurus, wherever your house number 2 is, wherever your Venus placement is, this is for you. House number 2, values. We're going to cut the deck. We'll clear it. We'll let it rest. Pranayama, breathing on the commute to work. I see you. You ever try it before you start your commute? Pranayama is one of the best ways to tap into our own personal connection with source. Absolutely. The breath is key. Breathing is everything. For house number 2, values, the message today, we cut the deck, we clear the energy, we let it rest. We shuffle over here. Also a little bit more present as well. That way you can actually give your full attention to that practice rather than trying to half-ass it. We cut the deck. we clear, and the goddess, we draw. House number two. We draw two off the top. Flip the root. Beautiful. Two of pentacles over here, in reverse. Abby, thank you for the gift, I appreciate you. Taurus here. House number two, we have the emperor in reverse for the collective, the sun of the morning. Can't half-ass the spiritual, nah, the universe isn't like that. It's all in, baby. Two of swords here for the collective, house number two. We have two of pentacles, two of swords. Lord of peace restored. Right now we're reading for the collective, Jessica. This is Taurus, house number two. We have the outsider here. We have participation here. We have turning in the root here. We have Uzume, the goddess of humor, here for the collective. Wendy, I got a Cash App from you. I see you. We'll be doing personal readings after all 12 houses. So, as I mentioned, we're reading for all 12 houses right now. I appreciate you jumping into the queue, Wendy. Though you will be up first in the personal readings this evening. Right now, we are going to be reading for all 12 houses, and we're on house number two, so we got a little bit. So sit back, relax, come back. Absolutely. Groovy. I see you, Abby. Welcome, my Taurus friends. Right now, we're being reminded of our own personal values that build our empire. The emperor here, in reverse, reminds you that you are the emperor of your reality. You are the soul. The body is your empire, your land. This is your earth. This is your space in which you get to call yours. The emperor calls the space theirs, right? Right now, we're shifting our perception from an external approach to this reality to an internal approach to reality. We're learning how to see everything external as a direct reflection of our internal state of being, and this allows us to participate in a much more wholesome way. It also allows us to not take shit so seriously, so we can be a little bit more humorous about this life. Because when we recognize that nothing external is real, everything that is material is illusory, it's always changing, when we can step back into the grand scheme of things and see things from a bigger picture, we can kind of laugh along. I think that the universe is constantly laughing. I'm pretty sure that the hum of the universe, the eternal ohm, is just one big ha ha ha. So for house number two, we're being called to ask, what do you value? What does value mean to you, and how you define that in your own personal reality through your relationships, through your connections, through your interactions? We got 1.1 likes up there, and it's 11:11 over here in the Midwest. Shouts out all you angels. I see you. Good signs all around. Right now, we're being reminded that it doesn't matter if we are perceived as an outsider when we are speaking from our truth, when we're living in our authenticity, because oftentimes in a world that is trying to shape you to be a very specific, myopic type of being, by choosing to be your authentic, unique self, this oftentimes will make you feel like an outsider of sorts. It doesn't matter. You're here to continue to turn inward and to show up as you are, regardless of how other people see it. This is how you also claim your power as the emperor, not holding back and continuing to step into your power as the individual who is secure within oneself. Getting to know yourself is one of the greatest things you can do on this journey of spirituality. Ultimately, I'm pretty sure that's the main goal, to see yourself as God, to see the divinity within everybody, especially you. Good to see you, gods. Good to see you, goddesses. We're going to keep flowing with it. Appreciate you being here with us today. House number three, Gemini, up next. Gemini, house number three is communication. The ruling planet of Gemini is Mercury, that planet of communication. Christina says, I'm a death doula. Can't take anything but love and knowledge with you. Facts, man. We are reading for the collective, all 12 houses. Shouts out Gemini Squad for all my Gemini Sun, Moon, Ascendants. I see you. I got a Gemini Moon as well. Yes, indeed, my dudes. Abby says, I needed those words. Thank you. Hey, fam, I'm glad to drop it in with you today. Shouts out all my Gemini babes. Gemini is communication, how we communicate our values, how we communicate our ego, how we communicate our authenticity. Yes, indeed. We are making our way through this evening, just here in channel mode, letting it flow right through. What a gift it is to be able to share these messages. Shouts out my Gemini Moon, allowing this conversation to unfold with ease and effortless capacity. Gemini, house number three. We cut the deck. We clear the energy. We let it rest. We're going to invite in a goddess for all you goddesses. Absolutely. two cards, actually three cards right side up, most of them in reverse. It seems that we're on a shift of change currently. When cards are in reverse, a lot of times I see that as like things are happening around the corner. It's in the near future, or the energy that we're meant to call in to begin integrating in these lessons. First, we have courage right side up for house number three, the collective. Courage. We have possibilities here, reverse. The dream here in the root. Alongside the death card here, reverse. Child of the great transformers, death. Lord of ruin, ten of swords here. Lord of ruin, reverse. We have two of pentacles once again in the root over here in the Hermetic Tarot. Lord of harmonious change. We definitely shuffled those cards, but it looks like this one's jumping in again for Gemini. And with the goddess, Yuki Onna, stillness here. This is for Gemini, house number three. Look up your natal chart if you want to know how the planets fall into your chart. Mage, thank you for the gift. I appreciate this. Right now, we're being reminded of the importance of stillness. Instead of always reacting to our subconscious, unconscious patterns and programs that have been bestowed upon us, either with our consent or without our consent, learning how to step out of our own way and speak from a space of clarity, from a space of stillness, speaking from a space of presence, slowing down. It takes courage to allow yourself to slow down, because sometimes there's a lot of pressure to respond, and people are like, I need you to react right now, I need you to respond, but that's not how we build dreams. Dreams take time. And we got to take our time, we got to allow ourselves a moment to slow down, to process the process, to decompress, to let all the noise clear, so we can speak clear. Gemini Moon is one of the best individuals to be able to communicate. Gemini Sun as well. Gemini Energy, house number three, is how you are communicating your values. So right now we're putting to rest, we're putting to death all of that which creates ruin in our life. All of the patterns, all of the limiting beliefs, because Gemini is also about belief energy. It's air, the first element of air. Air is the element of vision. Air is the element of communication. Air is the element of mental energy as well. So that what is creating separation from your imagination, because the imagination is one of the greatest tools there is that we can utilize to continue to create this reality. As we are shifting and changing, we're being reminded to invite in intention. How do you want your life to change? Because ultimately, the way you communicate, the way that you see and perceive your life is going to affect and influence how your life continues to play out. When you can slow down and step into this realm of stillness, this is where you tap into the eternal now, this present moment. And in this present moment, we are in a space of infinite possibility, which is so freeing, so exciting. Sometimes it takes a moment to get a hang of it, because we're so taught to always think of the past or the future rather than just being right here, right now. Right here, right now, the dream is happening organically, unfolding. So how can we sustain this? How can we maintain this? How can we cultivate this frequency so that this becomes our base level of being? We got to put an end, put to death any fear, any doubt, any worry, any communications that are existing within our mind that are not supportive of the dream. You're allowed to set boundaries for yourself. You're allowed to sit back into the seat of the witness and say, hey, these thoughts are not supporting me in my dream, and they do not deserve to live rent-free in my mind. Any doubt, any worry, any limiting beliefs, any thoughts or even projections from external reality, from other people who are trying to speak into your space, trying to convince you or influence you in a specific way, you are ultimately the creator, and you, at the end of the day, get to decide what agreements you are making and what is allowed to reside within your space and what is not. Yes. So as you continue to invite in intention, this is how you step into that Two of Pentacles energy, that Lord of Harmonious Change, and allowing that which is going to rest, go to rest. Ultimately, only the truth remains, and time will tell. Time will tell. So you really don't really got to do anything. You really just, the challenge is learning how to slow down, step into stillness. And if I could offer you any practical practices that might help you in this journey, is meditation. Slowing down and focusing on your breath daily, even if it's just for 5 breaths. I mean, I would recommend at least 5 minutes, but if that's too much for you at a time, you can even just do 5 intentional breaths where you're only focusing on breathing in and breathing out. And you're doing your best to bring your awareness to this process of breathing. to recognize you don't always have to react to everything. You can slow down and you can choose to move from a new space rather than a space of unconscious, subconscious patterns and programs, the ways that were creating ruin in your life. And instead, choosing to move forward with courage to the tune of infinite possibilities so that you can create the dream that it is that you want to see. Absolutely. Not saying it's easy. It's a daily practice, just like Taurus was reminding us, just like Aries was reminding us too. It's a daily practice. Every instant, in fact, we're provided the opportunity to choose stillness. We got this, house number three. We're flowing forward. House number four, Cancer, Sun, Moon, Ascendant. House number four is the home. So how our communications create our container, because the walls in which you are building for your reality, whether it's the home that you live in or your internal home, it is ultimately built on the way that you are envisioning and the way that you are communicating. House number four, Cancer, Sun, Moon, Ascendant. This one is for you. Cut it, clear it. Breathing, bringing the life force energy through the higher chakras to the throat, to the heart. Exactly. You know what you're doing, Christine. Breathing is life. Absolutely. The more we can breathe with intention, the more we can slow down into this present moment. Because ultimately, our breath is our tether to this right now, this present moment right now. Cancer, Sun, Moon, Ascendance, house number four, the home today. Any encouragement, any messages for the collective? Let's get it. See y'all, we got some Cancers in the house. All my crabs out here, I see you. Let's get to it, my dudes. Let's start over here. The foolish man, the fool, the spirit of the ether. The fool, alongside the magician in reverse, the magus of power, the magician. Temperance here, also in the reverse, daughters of the reconcilers, temperance. What an awesome card. We also have moment to moment here. Mage, thank you for that gift. Thanks for joining the team, squad. Possibilities once again. And isolation here in the root for Cancer, my dudes. The goddess Uzume makes another appearance today for house number four, humor. We're being reminded of the home within, to prioritize solitude, to prioritize connection with self, and to begin to develop that internal metaphysical home that begins right here in the core. But we utilize our mind's eye to envision it, but ultimately the home is right here in our heart space. How can we bring our awareness to our heart space on a more consistent basis? What helps is the posture, learning how to keep the shoulders open, rolling them back, bringing our breath to our heart. This is where the home is, in the core. The fool is an individual who is rooted in their home. They carry their home wherever they go, so they know that they are always safe, they are always supported, they are always in the perfect place at the perfect time with the perfect people, working in union with the universe. Noted. Thank you for the gift. I appreciate you. The magician and temperance here, in reverse, reminding us of inviting in magic into our life, into our heart, into our home. And magic has such an open-ended definition. Ultimately, you get to define it for yourself. But the fact that you are able to translate these words, which I'm communicating through this screen, you can pick it up on your screen, understand what I'm saying, and get a sense of what it is that I'm communicating, that's magic if you ask me. Magic doesn't have to be able to just move things with your mind. I mean, it can. That's pretty damn magical, don't get me wrong, but it can simply just start as being able to be grateful, because this life itself is magical. How the birds and the bees do their thing, how the flowers are continuously blooming. And it's honestly humorous how this world has created such myopic perception and attachments and expectations of what magic means, the definition of this. Right now we're being reminded to return to our solitude, our connection within. Isolation doesn't have to be taken so heavy of being by yourself, like where you feel isolated. The energy that we're getting with this message is prioritizing solitude and finding that balance, because we're always connecting with others, especially in work or socialization in the house and the family. But right now, we're also being reminded that it all begins within. The more we can continue to tap into our internal home, moment to moment, the more we can bring this energy with us, just like the Fool does. And when we do this, this is when we invite in that realm of infinite possibility to recognize that we are the creators of our reality, and ultimately what we say goes. You're allowed to do what you want here. This is your house. Know that there are... What is that word I'm looking for? Consequences. Every action has a consequence. Every action has an opposite and equal reaction, right? So this is why we're being reminded to practice temperance so that we can move forward with intention, listening to our intuition, and practicing intemperance so that we can move forward intentionally, and that we are honoring the message of our soul. We're honoring that flame within one's heart, that direction that is going to continue to point you in the direction of your magic, of your soul's mission here in this day and age. Every single moment we are provided this opportunity. Yes, indeed. House number four. We could spend the entire evening just geeking out on how this is one of the key aspects of life. Ultimately, when you know yourself, when you know your soul, this is when your house begins to unfold right before your very eyes. And then it also helps us to create our living space to influence this energy. You can move through your actual house, your external house, and you can make sure that everything that exists within your house is intentionally there. This will help us continue to facilitate, flow, and cultivate this energy of magic within our own personal space, so that this continues to play out in every single bit of our life. Solid. Thanks, house number four. What an important message. We're going to flow forward to house number five. Leo, sun, moon, ascendant. Do we have any Leos in the house? Sun, moon, ascendant. House number five is romance, passion, desire. It's also our light in which we're shining onto the world. Sometimes it's seen as the ego, but this is the next level to the ego. This is how our ego relates with our fellow egos as well, because Leo, we are here in a shared space. We're starting to make our way into the social signs. Yes, up next, Leo, house number five. Sun, moon, ascendant. I see you, all my lions in the house. Shouts out to you. We're going to get right to it. Leo, house number five. This is for you. We all have a fifth house within our chart. We know where that falls for you. Sun, moon, ascendant, Leo, house number five. Let's get to it.
Do I pray?
I pray every single day for a revolution. House number five. This is for you. A lot of cards in reverse today. Let's start here. The Miser. In the Root. Sensei, what a fantastic show. You already know Cinnamon Ray. The Miser. Traveling. Only two cards that are right side up. The Miser. Traveling. Another eight here. Letting go. Four of Pentacles here. Lord of the Earthly Power. Four of Pentacles in reverse. The Hierophant once again. Magus of the Eternal Gods. The Hermit here in the Root. Magus of the Voices of the Light. We have Yostre, the goddess of new beginnings here. The language of letting go, must read, noted. If I remember that, I'll add it to my list. Right now, Leo, house number five, we're reminded that as we step into our Leo energy, people are going to reflect their insecurities onto thee. People are going to project their own misery and their worries. Leos are some of the most powerful people out here in the house. And yet, for some reason, it's really triggering to a lot of people, especially people who are not secure in their skin, who are not secure in their connection with their spirit and their own personal magic. It doesn't matter. You keep traveling. You keep moving forward. You keep letting go. You don't hold on to a dang thing. You allow yourself to continue to move forward into the new beginnings, which are here around the corner for you. especially as you begin to tap into your earthly power and you create a consistent, diligent practice. The Hierophant here reminding us of consistency, persistence, perseverance, diligence, discipline. Yes, it's important to care for the self and to clean oneself metaphysically as well as physically so that you can continue to show up in your power. The Hermit is reminding you to return to your own personal power, to step into your own personal connection with the divine. This is how it continues to move through you in your own unique way. Absolutely. And you figure out what works for you. That's what the Hierophant is here all about. And this is how you tap into your earthly power. Ultimately, it's a real strong balance of showing up and letting go. Absolutely. This life, we are always traveling, and we are not here to waste our time, our effort, and energy on any miserly energy. The misery loves company, and you don't have to feed into it. You don't have to touch the fire in order to know that it's hot. Right now, we are shifting our perspective, and we're practicing compassion for ourselves. It's nice to practice compassion for other people, yeah, but also when we can practice compassion for ourselves, because you don't got to set yourself on fire in order to keep other people warm. Absolutely, Leo. This is a new beginning, this is a new initiation, this is a new chapter for house number 5, stepping into one's astrological cosmic essence, one's astros, one's, you are a star, your body is made of the same energy as the stars up in the sky, learning how to tap into it within yourself so you can let it unfold in your own unique way. Not easy, it's a daily practice, and ultimately what lights you up on the inside will point you in that direction. What you are passionate about, what you enjoy are the subtle signs that point you in that direction of your own personal connection and your personal magic. Absolutely. Pour from an overflowing cup, don't empty your own on others. Exactly. Ace of Cups energy. Leos, I feel like, are really good at this, but house number 5, it really depends on where your placements are, ultimately. I feel like Leos are naturally expressive and on their shit, but right now I'm getting more so this reading is for house number 5. Tap into one's own personal earthly power and the sun within. Absolutely. We are flowing forward to house number 6, Virgo. We're reading for all 12 houses today. Mars, we will be doing personal readings in a little bit if you want to come back, or you can kick it with us and listen to these collective readings. Right now we're reading for all 12 houses and we are now halfway there. House number 6, Virgo, sun, moon, ascendants, wherever you have Mercury in your chart. This recording will be up on my YouTube in a day or so, probably tomorrow. So if you want to catch it on the YouTube, you can find the YouTube in the links. Zen the Alchemist is the YouTube username if you'd like to check it in there. Nobody was good. You said you always come in at the right time. Perfect, perfect, perfect. I see you. Hi, Brittany. Welcome in. We are reading for house number 6, Virgo energy. Virgo is the work, how we apply our home, how we apply our communication, how we apply our uniquity, our desires, our ego, our values, how we show up on a daily basis and ground them into this earth. Shouts out, Virgo. Perfectly timed. We're going to cut this deck, clear this energy, and let it rest. I see you. Diligence. House number 6. The work. Inner voice over here in the root. The Zen Osho Tarot. Scorpio is house number 8. We are currently on house number 6, so we'll be in Scorpio in just a minute. Right now we got rebirth in the root. Rebirth. Slowing down here. Inner voice, rebirth, slowing down. 3 of Cups here, reverse. Lord of Abundance. 8 of Pentacles, right side up. Lord of Prudence. Virgo Sun. 9 of Swords, reverse in the root. Lord of the Winds and the Breezes. And Hecate, the goddess of the in-between here, for house number 6, Virgo. Virgo, I'm seeing a shift in your own personal reality. The fact that we have Slowing down, rebirth, and Hakate, the in-between here, is definitely reminding us of how things are always changing, but ultimately I'm seeing a big shift. I mean, we got the Virgo Sun here, Eight of Pentacles. That's a very solid synchronicity for Virgo, house number six, Lord of Prudence, reminding us of the importance of prudence, the importance of slowing down, the importance of taking our time, which I feel like Virgo is pretty good at. Virgo are some of the most intentional people I've ever gotten to interact with. They are very caring about how they place energy in their space. Intentional is key. Jamie, thanks for the gift. Thanks for joining that team. Knight of Swords in the root in reverse is reminding us of the importance of communicating our intentions into the space and how this will facilitate how the energy then flows throughout our reality. This is how we then open up to the Three of Cups energy, that Lord of Abundance just overflowing. Listen to your inner voice. Your inner voice will point you in the direction of your intuition, will point you in the direction of your intentions, and allow yourself to let yourself shed this skin. I'm getting caterpillar transforming into butterfly energy, this rebirth card here. So right now, just be easy on yourself, be graceful on yourself, allow yourself that time. Like, the real work is actually just challenging yourself to be patient, to be prudent, to be temperate, to slow down, to take your time, and let things unfold organically. You don't gotta rush a dang thing. It's all happening already. The more you can get out of your own way and align with the flow of reality, align your own personal desires with your destiny, this is how you'll continue to step into your divinity, your God gifts, and what it is that you are here to do today. Virgo, the real work is getting out of your own way and learning how to flow, which I know it can be a challenge for you because Virgos like to make sure everything is happening. They like to be on top of it. Power to you, Virgos. Good to see you. Prudence is key, and abundance will just flow effortlessly. I wish you easy transitioning in your rebirthing and the in-between. Patience, passion, persistence. Sixth house, I see you. Thank you, Virgo. What a powerful message. Absolutely, house number six. Number seven, Libra, up next. This is relationship. Libra is the balance. This is connections. This is communication. Second, air sign of socialization. Libra is balance, the scales. House number seven for you today. What's good, neighbor? Welcome in. We are reading for the collective. We are reading through the astrological signs, all 12 houses. Right now, we are on house number seven, Libra. Sun, moon, ascendants, wherever you may have this placement, as well as... Venus. We'll cover that. We'll clear it. We'll let it rest. Libra, house number seven. First, we have projections here. Projections in the root of the Zeno Shotero. House number seven, we have the seven card here. Projections. We have the outsider here. Reverse. We have control here. We have the Lord of Unstable Efforts here. Another seven. Seven of Swords for house number seven. Lord of Unstable Efforts in reverse. Four of Wands here. Right side up. Lord of Perfected Work, once again. And Knight of Wands for the collective, house number seven, Lord of Flame and Lightning. Alongside Bridget, the goddess of creativity, the creative spark. House number seven. Right now, we're being invited to practice some level of delusion, some level of like living in your own personal world. I'm getting this energy of, by doing so, by committing to your own personal perception of reality, you're dissolving all the projections of this external reality and how it's attempting to make you, convince you to live a very specific way. Like everything that society attempts to convince us to do, what is the word I'm looking for? gender roles, social programming, all of the little details that society attempts to convince an individual of what it means to be human and how to be a contributing member to society, we're moving into a time and space where that does not really apply anymore. So now you're here to continue to commit to yourself, perfecting your own personal work. Yeah, systemic. All of those nonsensical projections that society attempts to keep us in boxes with. Libra, we're bringing balance back to it because this has been happening for thousands of years, but now the individual is waking up and they're reclaiming their divinity, they're reclaiming their power, and it's happening at the speed of lightning. Right now we're waking up rapidly, and this is what the Four of Wands energy is encouraging us to do, to continue to perfect our work and establish our connection with self, our connection with creation, and continue to practice our creativity. For society, their efforts are unstable and they're dissolving right before our very eyes. We're seeing an amazing, immense shift in reality right now. And you cannot be controlled. Even if you're perceived as an outsider, as you step into your divinity, as you step into your uniquity, as you step into your God-given gifts, who cares if you're seen as an outsider? In fact, this will light the fire even a little bit more. This is how you know that you're doing the right thing, because you're setting the tone. You're one of the first. Those listening to this who are taking this to heart, you are rare. Power to you. And out of 55 of you, what, 9 billion people in the world? That's a rarity. That's a rarity. So continue to commit to your personal practice, establishing your tone, your unique frequency, so you can show up in your own personal divinity, show up in your creativity, show up in your role as a divine being in this life, so that we can continue to develop new earth, bringing heaven onto this world, which is what we are here to do. Libra, you're bringing it back to balance. Thank you for holding it down. Thank you for shining as a beacon. Power to you. Keep up the good work. You just being yourself just completely tears down the walls. You don't have to try. You don't have to fight. You don't have to impress or validate. You don't need validation or external confirmation or affirmation from anybody. You already got it. So just keep doing it. You cannot be controlled. Do not be held back. And in fact, I encourage you to find your edge and continue to go as far as you can. Go as far as you can. No need to hold back anymore. Lay it all on the line, honestly. Shouts out house number 7. Flow forward to house number 8, Scorpio energy. I see you today. Scorpio sun, moon, ascendance, or if you got a Pluto placement, house number 8 is transformation, death, and marriage. House number 8 is the depths beyond definition, Scorpio energy. Here for it. House number 8. Scorpios in the house, I see you. Let's get to it. Got an extra card for you. Start here. 9 of Swords. 9 of Swords, Lord of Despair and Cruelty. Guten Morgen. Salutations, Germany. Welcome in. We are reading for house number 8. Scorpio, Lord of the Roots and the Powers of Air. Ace of Swords here. Ace of Swords, 9 of Swords, the Universe in Reverse. The Great Ones, the Nighttime. We have the Existence, jumping in an extra card for Scorpio. Letting Go here. Patience, Reverse. Understanding here in the root. And we have patterns here. Ellen, the goddess of patterns, number 12 for house number 8. Scorpio, sun, moon, ascendance, Pluto placement today. We're being called to slow down, to practice patience. I feel like house number 8, Scorpios are quick to react. At times they are sharp. They like to make sure that they're on it. You know, like a Scorpio tail, they will gladly sting somebody who is attempting to disrespect them. That's a powerful aspect of house number 8. But right now, you're being called to hold back instead of reacting right away. and instead choosing to practice patience so you can allow the patterns to reveal themselves. Naturally, it's all happening organically, and as you get out of your own way, the understanding, the knowing, the lessons that are here to be learned will reveal themselves. Right now, you're just here to sit in the seat of the witness and practice, simply just being in existence without the need to shift or change anything. Letting go of the need to always react from a subconscious, unconscious space, and instead wielding your mind's eye, your power, your vision, so that you can then utilize this with the utmost intention and cut through any despair, any cruelty, anything that's attempting to create disharmony within your well-being. The universe is always going to make its way back to symbiosis, always going to make its way back to harmony. It's its natural state of being. Right now, we're being called to reflect on our own personal patterns. We're being called to reflect on our own personal patterns and how they play out. Cheryl, we've already done house number 4, Cancer. If you want to check out the recording, it's going to be up on my YouTube tomorrow. You can check that out on the links. Yes, right now we are in house number 8, Scorpio, going forward in order. Scorpio, we're being reminded to reflect on our own personal ways in which we've been navigating this space, which we've been going throughout our lives and seeing how the patterns play out, because ultimately everything is always playing out in patterns. This life is built on sacred geometry, and the patterns play out in fractals. Indeed, the more we can let go of those patterns that are no longer serving thee and step into a new way of being, the more we can upgrade into our power, our God-given gifts. What it is that we are here to do, to show up as creators, co-creators of this reality, as the universe. You are the universe. You are the universe. You are not your body. Your body is an expression, an extension of you and your universe. The more you can get out of your own way and stop feeding into energies and slow down so that these lessons present themselves to you and you can be open to them, allowing yourself a moment to process the process, and you're not feeding into any patterns of despair and cruelty, and instead you're feeding into patterns of letting go, of taking a break, and recognizing that your energy is precious, and what you feed will continue to grow. So how you are reacting will show the universe what it is that you want to continue to perceive in your reality, which is kind of ironic at times, especially for Scorpios who love to stand up for themselves, and I don't blame you. Yes. But at the same time, I want to let you practice water on a duck's back, just like letting shit go that's not important, that doesn't need to be reacted to all the time. You got it, house number 8. This is the transformation right before your very eyes. We are flowing forward tonight with house number 9, Sagittarius. Yes, yes, yes. Thanks, Scorpio. What a solid message. House number 9, Sagittarius. Sun, moon, ascendant. Wherever your Jupiter placement is, house number 9 is higher wisdom. House number 9 is guidance from the upper realms, how we can tap into this infinite intelligence that exists within every bit of our experience. Welcome in, all my dudes. It's good to see you. Right now, we are reading for the collective, all 12 houses. Right now, we got house number 9, Sagittarius. A lot of repetitive cards today. Only 2 right side up. Let's get to it. In the root over here for house number 8, we have schizophrenia, number 2, Sag. Shouts out Lil Sims. Lil Sims is a legend, living legend. Sagittarius, we have politics here, right side up. Letting go once more in reverse. Letting go, politics, schizophrenia, we have justice here. Daughters of the Lord of Truth. 4 of Pentacles making another appearance. Lord of the earthly powers. And the universe, once again, reversing the root over here. Sag, house number 9. We also have Sophia, divine wisdom. Sag, literally being the element of divine wisdom. Some perfect synchronicity to see Sophia jumping in today. Absolutely. Absolutely. Sophia, for you, dear friend, we have The reminder of how this world attempts to keep us in a box. How this society tries to convince the individual that if you're receiving information from external sources or internal sources, you could be perceived as crazy. The politics of this world has attempted to keep the individual in a box for some time to disconnect them from their intuition. And we are here to let go of all that nonsense and bring justice to our destiny and our ability to step into our earthly power and reclaim our roles here in the universe, because we all have an important role to play in the universe. We are all here to show up with our soul's mission, your destiny, what it is that you chose to do before you were birthed into this reality. That divine wisdom, the intelligence, the intuition is what's going to continue to point you in that direction. Do not listen to the insecurities. Do not worry about if you are received or not, how other people may perceive you based on what it is that you are taking in right now. Sagittarius, we're being reminded to double down on our divine wisdom, that internal guidance that it is that I'm going to ask everybody to be mindful in the comment section. I will gladly mute anybody who's being disrespectful in the chat. And even if you're just like being the only person who's commenting, that's disrespectful. We're all sharing this space here. Clearly, I'm beautiful. I don't need you to comment that. Sagittarius. We're here to let go of all the projections of the politics and the schizophrenia. All the nonsense that people were trying to be like, oh, bro, you believe in tarot? You believe in magic? You believe in astrology? You're crazy. Nonsense. Nonsense. You're here to continue to step into your power, to embody your divine wisdom. You're here to continue to ground into your earthly guidance. And this is how you will be open to all the signs and the synchronicities that the universe wants to show for you. Absolutely. Groovy, my dudes. We're going to keep flowing forward to house number 10, Capricorn energy. Finnegan, are you here? Brother, are you here? I got your Cash App. We're going to be doing personal readings after this live stream. We're going to take like maybe a 15-minute break or so. Get a little snack. Right now we are in house number 10. It's good to see you, brother. I see you. I'll be glad to draw some cards for you in a moment. Right now, we are going to flow forward. We got house number 10, 11, 12. Take a brief break. We're going to be right back. So if you want to come back, I'll be glad to draw for you today. Same for Wendy. Wendy, are you here? I also got your Cash App. Absolutely. Flowing forward for the squad. Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Ascendance, house number 10. This is our disciplines. This is how we build our foundations, our structures of our reality, how we utilize that divine wisdom to make an entire world of it. Wendy, I see you. Beautiful. Awesome, my dudes. Like I said, we will be doing personal readings after this live stream, so don't think I'm just going to jump off here and not come back. I'll jump off here. That way I can keep this recording and upload it to my YouTube tomorrow, and then we will flow forward. So if you want to hit that notification, that bell, so you know when we get back on. But I'm sure you'll know. Absolutely. All right. House number 10, Sun, Moon, Ascendance, wherever you have a Saturn placement, wherever your 10th house is. Let's do this. Dang. Four of Wands has been so prevalent today. What in the world? I gotta shuffle a little bit more. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe these messages just want to keep playing out. Universe here. Reverse. Once again, I think I'm going to have to shuffle this deck a little bit more. Universe in the root. Four of Pentacles. Four Capricorn, my dudes. Lord of Perfected Work. Princess of Wands here in reverse. Princess of the Spiraling Fire. Shining Flame. Guidance here. Reverse. The Master. Here, right side up. Rebirth here. Very strong Capricorn energy. Very strong 10th house Saturn reading. Saturn, not Sagittarius, Saturn. Artemis, the goddess of focus. Yes, we are becoming in alignment. We are shifting on a collective level. Saturn is situated in Pisces right now, and Saturn in Pisces is a very new time, where we get to build a reality based on the dream, where we get to ground into the dreams so that we can continue to grow and evolve indeed Indeed, indeed. Right now we're being called to listen to our internal guidance and how it presents itself. We're being called to listen to the princess of flames, that fire within, that spark within your heart, that which lights you up will continue to point you in that direction of your dreams. I'm sure everybody can hear me just fine. You're the first person to comment that, so maybe you gotta turn up your volume a little bit. Four of Wands here. Four of Wands here, perfecting that work of listening to your guidance, listening to your personal intuition, that fire within, that spark within your heart, so that you can continue to step into your power of your role here in the universe. Artemis, the goddess of focus, here reminding us that this is diligence, this is persistence, this requires dedication and devotion. This is not something that just happens once and then you're done. No, we're rebirthing our reality and our way of navigating this life and stepping into this world. Right now, we are prioritizing our flame over everything. We're prioritizing our own personal magic over anything else. That which is happening within is going to point you in the direction of where you need to be externally, without. Yes, may you continue to focus and practice divine discernment, setting your ground and your boundaries, and recognizing what energies are allowed in your space and what energies you will not any longer entertain. And if that means telling someone to get the fuck out of my face, you're allowed to do that. You're allowed to do that. In the universe, you are, and you're here to continue to recognize that you are in direct communication with the universe in real time, always. The signs, the synchronicities, the omens will point you in the direction that will guide you to continue to be in your path and practice of self-mastery, so you may continue to step into your Princess of Wands energy, your fire, your role here, and then perfecting this work, grounding into this magic, recognizing that this is your base frequency. You wake up like this, lit, ready to go, ready to get started, ready to continue to step into your role as Artemis, the goddess of the moon, listening to your intuition. Shouts out Sagittarius, shouts out Capricorn, Saturn energy, excuse me, Sagittarius Queen, I got you on the Cash App. You're going to be added to our queue for our personal readings. Absolutely, we magical as soul fam, that's right, squad's all here, so good to be here. It's only going to get better. We are just, like, we're in the preface of the preface. Like, we're at the part of the book where you're still seeing, like, the acknowledgments. We're at the part of the book where we're seeing, like, this book was written in 2012. And these are all the people who have contributed to this book. And these are the people who have published this book. Like, we haven't even started the preface yet. We haven't even started chapter one yet. We are just getting started on a collective level. So hang in there, friends. If you're here, you are early to the party. Shouts out to you. We love it when people get early to the party. This ain't one of those parties where you gotta show up late. You started the party. You're one of the people who got to create the space. Thank you for being here and playing such an important role today. We're flowing forward. House number 11, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Ascendance, wherever you got Uranus placement, Aquarius, house number 11. This is collective energy. This is how we show up and build the world together. Yes, yes, yes. Aquarius, the water bearer. This is, excuse me, not Uranus. Uranus. Yeah. Jupiter, Sagittarius, yeah. But I feel like Jupiter, personally, I got a Jupiter in Aquarius. That's where that wanted to be spoken in this space. But yeah, Team Aquarius, I see you. Shouts out my water bearers, my dudes doing the real work as we're stepping into the Aquarian age. Wherever you got house 11 today, this is for you, collective. Thank you for the gift. I appreciate this. Right now we are reading for house number 11. Let's shuffle this deck two more times just because we're going to see if it was the shuffling or if those cards really wanted to play. Love that sound. We are indigo. Let's get it. House number 11. Welcome in, welcome in. We are reading for Aquarius. Wherever you got 11th house placement, this is for you, collective. By intuition, you should listen. God's whisper. The fool, the foolish man, the spirit of the ether in the root and reverse for the collective. The lovers here, Aquarius, for you. Children of the voices of the vine. Wheel of fortune here. Lord of the forces of life, also in reverse. Lovers right side up, the fool reverse, wheel of fortune reverse. Maturity here, house number 11. The source here. Fighting here in the root. And Bridget here. This is Aquarius, house number 11. Bridget, the goddess of creativity, the creative spark. House number 11. We're seeing on a collective level, we're maturing. We're evolving. We're stepping deeper into our own personal connections with Source, as well as on a collective level. That which ignites fighting within you, that what it is that you want to combat, that what it is that you resist, persists. Also, that which you are fighting is a greatest teacher. If you can see that what it is that you are attempting to resist or fight as a teacher, rather than just feeding into that fighting energy, you can reclaim your power and step into your divinity. The Wheel of Fortune here, Lord of Forces of Life, is showing us that everything is happening. Organically, the wheels are turning. We are bringing in an age of enlightenment. It is happening naturally. The more you can connect to yourself, you can see yourself as God. You can connect to your masculine and your feminine and bring them into union within, starting the lovers within your own personal God and goddess. The more you can then bring them to fruition, let it play out right before your very eyes. It's a daily practice. And when you do it, you begin to develop a force about you, shall we say. Yes, you commit to this path as a way of being. We all have this capacity. And ultimately, the fool is one of the greatest examples of this. They naturally do this without even realizing it. And sometimes we take a step back from that. You know, as we mature, as we evolve, we're like, oh, the fool, I can't be a fool. I got to show up and be serious. But ultimately, the fool is actually a very perfect embodiment of the lovers and just moving through life as if everything is working in their favor. An individual who is in love with themselves, in love with life, will continue to shine as an example of the divine. You don't need to fight anymore. Instead, we're being called to move into faith, move to the frequency of fortune rather than fighting. That what it is that you feel that fighting within you will point you in the direction, but when you can collapse that energy, when you can return to peace within, you're reclaiming your power, you're not feeding into negativity, and you're choosing to uplift the frequency so you can move into the positive polarity. This is creation within itself. It's very creative to be able to practice alchemy. It might not be just like, oh, I'm making art. I love making art, don't get me wrong. And at the same time, you can live your life as an artful way of being. As you continue to harmonize, step into your divinity, as you continue to bring your masculine and your feminine into union, this is creation within itself. Keys, keys, keys. And as you start with yourself personally, you're creating portals for the collective to do the same. And then we're creating a new world right before our very eyes. And all you had to do was be yourself. Who would have thought? Aquarius energy. Simple. Much easier said than done. Every single day we're provided the opportunity to practice this. Yes, yes, yes. The fool reminds you to move forward with innocence, with a sense of getting... I love to associate the fool card with Finn, the human energy, Finn from Adventure Time. Yes, he just moves through life as if like he's on top of his shit for the most part. I mean, he does got some episodes where he's like in his feels, which is very important. But like right now, like when he's in an adventure mode and he's ready to go do what the universe has brought him to do, like, that's an individual who just moves forward without any concern, because they know that the earth is holding them up and gravity is holding them down, and they're here right now, ready to grow, ready to evolve, ready to step into their power. Let's do it. Aquarius, house number 11. Shouts out. Thanks for this message. Pisces, best for last. I'm a little biased. I got a stellium in Pisces. House number 12. This is the space beyond definition. House number 12, this is beyond the subconscious and the unconscious. This is the imagination. This is that which cannot be defined. Pisces is the dreamer, the individual who is open to evolution. Pisces, house number 12, wrapping up the readings today. Sun, moon, ascendance, wherever you got a Neptune placement. This is for you, my friends. Buongiorno. Miss Italiano is muy pequeño. Nonetheless, it's good to see you. House number 12 for you, my dudes. Sun, Moon, Ascendant, Pisces, placements, wherever you got it. This is for you. We'll cut the deck. We'll clear it. We will let it rest. It is a beautiful day. I appreciate you, Tay. It is good to see you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, a great song indeed. Shouts out, old Jay. Breeze locks, baby. I love you so. All of you. Absolutely. Mello, thank you for those roses. Right now, we are reading for house number 12, my friends. Let's do this. Love's gonna heal us. Again and again. Pisces placements. Of course we get these cards. This is how you know we're in sync. Yes, baby, let's do this. First, we get Beyond Illusion here, house number 12. This is a perfect card to represent Pisces, those who are naturally beyond illusion. In fact, having a stellium in Pisces, I can say it's really natural for me to be beyond the illusion and sitting at the edge of the universe, and it's actually challenging to learn how to be in body. That's one of my personal lessons in this journey, is learning how to ground into my body so that I can show up here and be present and continue consistently. We have trust here for the collective. Trust, beyond illusion, we have harmony here. House number 12, harmony in the root. We have the High Priestess here, reverse, the Priestess of the Silver Star, and the Hermit here, right side up, Magus of the Voices of Light. We have Eight of Swords here, Lord of Shorn Force in the root for the collective, Pisces Fish. Lord of Shorn Force, Eight of Swords, and Hestia, home. The goddess of home, Hestia, reminding us that we are building our home in this reality, not just in our house, but our home everywhere we go. This is also a very strong Aquarian age. You can be yourself wherever you go. And first, it begins with you connecting to your own personal source. You're clearing your chakras, showing up present in your body. The Hermit here is reminding you of your path of the individual, your unique expression, and how this is where your power stems from. The High Priestess in reverse is reminding us that as we allow ourselves time to get down to ourselves, that Hermit energy, this is how we can find our magic. Abby, thanks for that gift. Thanks for joining the team. Pisces, house number 12. As you continue to commit to yourself and your path of the individual, this is where you will find your personal magic. The High Priestess, building your home wherever you go. You, house number 12, are the anchor of Beyond Illusion. You are holding down the fort of what it means to see through all of the facades that this world is attempting to bestow upon us. And instead, you are choosing to harmonize rather than reject it, rather than to vilify all these illusions that we see. You are simply by being, requiring reality to then harmonize with you. You establishing your personal frequency and doubling down on this whenever there is someone attempting to doubt you or limit you. Instead, you choose to maintain your boundaries of your home within and all around thee, which is then shortening the forces that are attempting to convince you or point you in a direction that is not you. Because this world, the society in which we live, has a very specific, myopic lens of how it wants its people to operate. It has very limiting programming and conditioning that attempts to keep the individual stuck in a rut so that it can feast on your innocence and your suffering. Whether it's doing that consciously or unconsciously is not for me to say. Ultimately, we are here to continue to trust that we are doing right. We are doing the right thing to continue to burn down these walls, break down these walls, dissolve the illusions that this society has attempted to keep the people stuck in boxes and very limited ways of perceiving reality, and instead choosing to navigate their life from a state of harmony. This is how we reclaim our power, because nature is ultimately yearning for harmony all of the time. Nature is always returning to harmony and symbiosis, and it seems that the society in which we have inherited has claimed more on nature herself. Just by you getting to know yourself as nature and your own personal connection to nature, your own personal nature, you are then creating harmony within yourself, within all the cells within your body. And then this will then permeate through every pore of your person, which will then encourage the rest of the world around you to also harmonize. And when we're all moving in harmony, ooh, this is when the divinity really starts to take shape. And we've hardly even gotten glimpses of this yet in this lifetime. Maybe you've gotten a little tastes of it when you're at a concert and you're singing along with other people and you're feeling like, what in the world am I feeling right now? That's heavenly energy. It really is heavenly energy when all the people are in union together, all experiencing something similar at the same time, enjoying it. Just like we're doing right now, vibing out, co-creating this space. What a joy it is to continue to hold down this frequency so that we can continue to create heaven on earth. Synchronicity is key. Symbiosis is the mission. Symbiosis is the mission. We are here to show up as individuals. And in doing so, we are reclaiming our power as the creators of our reality. We're stepping into our divinity, which if you ask me is the goal. To get to know yourself and how you can continue to let it flow through God Squad. We're out here. Power to you. We all do it in our own way and no one can do it for you. The more you do it, the better you get at it. So keep doing it. Even whether you're just getting started or you've been doing this for ages. Keep uplifting the frequency, the vibes indeed. Just be yourself and we do it. Sarah says she missed Leo. Not a worry. You can catch the recording on my YouTube tomorrow at the latest. It'll be up there. It might be up there tonight, but I think it'll be up there tomorrow. Yes, yes, yes. And that's it. House number 12. Solid readings. We just flowed right through this. Channel mode. Love it, love it, love it. Powerful readings tonight. Continue to see through the illusions. Ultimately, it's the frequency. This is for house 12, wherever you may be in your chart. So if you got a Pisces ascendant, it definitely can resonate. But ultimately, we all have house number 12 in our chart. So however it plays out for you, indeed, my dudes. May you continue to see through the illusion and allow yourself to tap into that frequency of truth. That frequency of truth is ultimately what we are yearning for. Seeing through the form and tapping into the frequency, this is where the message ultimately speaks. And you can feel the frequency in your emotions and how you feel about a situation. But it's also important that you're asking yourself, like, is this from a conditioned feeling or is this feeling from a divine discernment, from a clear space? If you are steady doing that work to keep yourself clear in your presence, you'll have a greater understanding. But if you still have energy that needs to be processed, it's important to continue to process that process so you can step into what it is that you wish. Any sites you recommend for birth charts? I always like to use Astro Cafe. Yes, if you Google natal charts, I think Astro Cafe will usually be one of the first ones. Or maybe it's Cafe Astrology. No, I think it's Astro Cafe. Yeah, that's the one I usually like to go to personally. Hope, thanks for those gifts. I appreciate you. Finnegan, I see you. I have not forgotten. Wendy, I see you. Sag Queen, I see you on the Cash App. Laura, we're going to flow forward. I'm going to take a break. We're going to get back on here around 12:30. Going to jump out of here, get myself some snack, some food. Cafe Astrology. Yeah, super good stuff. And then we're going to flow forward. We're going to jump back on here in like 15 minutes for personal readings. So if you'd like to get back here and receive a personal reading for the day, I'd be glad to read these cards for you. Don't you not have fire in your chart too? I have hardly any fire in my chart. Facts, yeah. Very, very watery in my chart. Absolutely. But I got a fifth house sun, stellium. So that's how the fire plays out for me. Yes. Anyway, you can check. The recording on the YouTube. And I just want to let y'all know that we will be leading a one-of-a-kind live workshop this Thursday where we'll be diving deep into the tarot, the deck, where we'll be teaching the language. If you'd like to learn about the tarot, whether you've been learning them for a lifetime or you just got started, we'll be sharing the space via Zoom where we'll be diving into the transcendental technology that is the tarot to help you dive deeper into your own personal practice, get to know the cards in your own way so you can continue to read for yourself and those around you. So if that is something of interest to you, you can purchase general admission at Zen the Alchemist. Know that there are like 5 fake accounts out there right now. I counted 5 fake accounts out there right now trying to impersonate me. So obviously I must be doing something good if there are 5 fake accounts out there trying to impersonate me. If there's anybody who's trying to use my name and my stuff It's fake. Report them, block them, ignore them, do what you need to do, but I promise you I will never try to slide into your DMs and sell you a reading. I won't follow you back either, no offense. I only follow my mutuals and squad out here, and if we've been connecting for a while, we've built friendship, I will follow you back, but I'm never going to try to slide into your DMs and sell you a reading. So if someone tries to do that, just report them, ignore them, block them. Appreciate y'all being here today. Ty, I see you. We do have 3 in the queue, so I'm going to wrap up this live stream. I'm going to go get myself some water and a snack, and we'll be back for the personal readings. If you want to jump into the queue, we'll be back here at 12:30 EST, 15 minutes, wherever you may be on the clock on your side. I'll see you soon. Take care, my dudes.